Whether you're a beginner or a seasoned professional, writing is difficult. However, there are 10 Google Chrome extensions or apps that help make the writing process easier. These tools are truly gems because they make you more efficient and effective during the writing process. The first gem is MyBib. Now, what makes MyBib different is that you don't need to identify your source and input a bunch of information. You can simply pull up an article, click on the extension, choose your style of formatting, and it creates a citation for you. Here, I'll choose MLA-8 formatting, and then I'll simply click to copy. I notice that the citation is missing some information, so I can simply edit it by clicking on the edit button on the right-hand corner. I still highly recommend you use a proper reference book like your MLA-8 handbook, etc., so you can double check and make sure the formatting details and information is correct. Once I update this information, I'll have the perfect citation. The next few extensions are all meant to help you become better readers because good writing starts with analytical reading. Lookup is a great extension that allows you to look up a word's meaning simply by clicking on a word in an article. Here, for example, I double-click on the word bemoaning. Right-click to find the lookup extension, and I can choose from various dictionaries to define the word. While we read, it's easy to ignore a word we don't know and to just keep reading, but using an efficient tool like this can increase your comprehension so you can better respond to the article when you write about it. Next up is Mercury Reader. This is a great tool to clear out the clutter, especially if your reading is on a busy website in which everything is vying for your attention. Watch this article transform into a beautiful, clean page like this one without any distractions. Click on Settings to toggle between light and dark mode, change the typography, and change the size of the text. My next favorite tool is Commie. Commie is this amazing tool that allows you to interact with your reading so that you're critically thinking about how to use a source in your own writing. When you click on the Commie extension, you have the option to upload scanned readings and use the OCR tool to turn the scans into clickable text or simply upload your own PDF. I'm going to upload the PDF I saved a minute ago here. Just for comparison, here is a scanned PDF. I can't click on anything, I can't highlight anything, and it's not interactive as you can see. In Commie, on the other hand, I can easily click anywhere and highlight text and annotate and comment on it. So let's take a look at these tools. There are lots of great annotation tools, but not too many that it becomes overwhelming. You can mark up by underlining, highlighting, changing the color of those items right here. Now, be aware that I am using the free trial, which is a generous 90 days. So video and voice commenting and some of the other tools are not available in the normal free version. Once you're done commenting on your article, you can share it, save it, print it, download it. You have lots of options up here. And don't forget to use this in class when you're discussing your readings, so that way you have all of your notes in front of you and you can easily participate. The next extension is Picture in Picture. If you've ever had to toggle between tabs to try to take notes on a video, or better yet, try to resize your windows so that way you can see both screens, you'll love this extension, which seamlessly brings the video to you. All you do is click on your video, click on the Picture in Picture extension. Play your video, and it will automatically bring the video into your word processor, your Google Docs, your Microsoft Word, whatever it is. And the best part about it is that you can easily resize it, so you can take notes while you watch your video. The next gem is Read Aloud. If you prefer to listen to your readings rather than actually read them, then this is the tool for you. All you do is click on the Read Aloud extension.
Political correctness isn't killing comedy, it's making it better.
And you can see that this box pops up, and all of this is actually the contents of this article. So it highlights for you what the speaker is saying. You can always turn that feature off. But if you listen to it, it's actually a natural sounding voice as opposed to a robotic voice.
Diversity among comedians and audiences makes room for more laughs.
So you're more apt to listen when it's a less robotic voice. You can always change the font here if you want to read along while you listen. And if you go back to the settings here, you can always change the voice, the speed, the pitch, the volume, and change the highlighting if you wish. In addition to using this tool for reading, I also use it during the writing process. For example, after I finish writing a draft or I'm done with my final copy, I use Read Aloud so it reads my essay to me aloud and I can pick up on any mistakes that I didn't catch while I was writing it. The next extension is MindMup. Now, once you've done your readings and taken notes on them, you can then start to brainstorm using MindMup. I love using MindMup because it maps out my ideas and I can visually see how all of my ideas are connected to each other. I create a bunch of notes here to show the connections to my thesis. I think this is really important to see visually because when we write, we sometimes get lost in the details and forget to link our pieces of evidence or points to the thesis. Here, I'm copying and pasting random sentences from the article to stand in as evidence. And then I export it to create an outline, making sure to include my notes. And then it opens it up in either Microsoft Word or Google Docs, depending on your settings. You can see I have a working outline here, which then I can flesh out into a draft. The next extension is ProWritingAid. This extension supports you as you draft and edit your writing. ProWritingAid points out grammar issues and provides thorough explanations for each error. You can either import a document into their platform or run ProWritingAid while you're working in Google Docs. I'm going to click on View a Sample so you can see how it works. The program underlines all of the issues that arise in your document. So here you have a simple spelling error and it explains what is a spelling mistake. Here there's confused word, so lots of grammatical issues, and it also provides lots of information as to how to fix those issues. This top bar has a lot of great tools like help with transitions, help with overused words, and a thesaurus. So this is a really great source to use again while you're drafting and editing to ensure that your writing is clear and effective. The next free tool is Plagiarism Checker from prepostseo.com. Once you have a draft, you'll want to ensure that you're not plagiarizing. This quick free tool points out sentences containing matches from outside sources. Let's take a look at how it works. So let's say I wanted to use this line as a quote in my essay. So I'm going to copy and paste it here. And I forgot to add in the quotation marks as well as the in-text citation because life happens, right? So I'm going to then remember to check for plagiarism by going to the Plagiarism Checker extension. And you can either paste your text here or attach your document and simply click on the Check Plagiarism button. And down here, it tells me that this is plagiarized. and it tells me where this sentence is coming from. This is a really great tool to use when you are drafting your essay, because sometimes we forget to add quotation marks or in-text citations, and this calls attention to all of the matches that are happening, so that way you can remember to go back and add all of the necessary information in order to avoid plagiarism.
Finally, we have talk and comment.
All good writing students share their work with each other and leave constructive criticism. You can always use the commenting tools in Google Docs or Microsoft Word, or if you want to leave voice notes, you can use talk and comment. This extension hovers on the right side of your screen after it's installed, and all you do is click on it and talk and say your comment. I think you need an in-text citation and quotation marks here. Then you click on the green circle and your voice is automatically copied to your clipboard. So you click OK, and instead of this comment, I'm going to paste my voice note and click on comment. And what I love about it is it turns it into this cute icon, and your peer editing partners can and talk and say your comment. Simply listen to it, and if they prefer written comments, you could always do that, but this is a great way to personalize your feedback and constructive criticism.